Hi, are you trying to set up your Khadas device headlessly? If you do, you're in the right place. As promised last week, I will show you step by step how to set up your Khadas VIM or Edge device this way. I'll demonstrate this on the Khadas VIM 1S device. Still, the process will be almost identical for other Khadas VIM and Edge devices. And if you're wondering what headlessly means, it means without a display keyboard or mouse actually connected to the device. There are a few things you will need. You'll need your x86 or x64 main computer. I mean like your PC or notebook on which you'll create the proper image. We'll also need a microSD card and card reader. And that's about it. Let's do this. So, first thing first. If you're not using Linux on your main computer, you would need to install one. You can do it as a dual boot or run Linux in a virtual machine using something like VirtualBox or VMware. I'll be building a Debian image for my VIM 1S, so I've downloaded and installed the x64 version of Debian 11 on a virtual machine on my Windows PC. I've chosen Debian because it's known for its rock-solid stable release. If you need to learn how to create a virtual machine, check out the link in the video up in the corner. Okay, so how do we create this image for the Khadas device? We'll use this tool designed for us by Khadas people. It's called the Fenix script and you can download it from GitHub. The link will be, as always, down in the description. We'll make sure Git is installed and that we have all the tools we need to compile Khadas image. Sudo apt install git make lsb release and qemu user static and vim. And clone the Fenix script repository. Make dir-p home project Khadas, cd home project Khadas, git clone depth 1, github.com/khadas/fenix, cd Fenix. Now we need to tell the script what we want to do, and we do it by running this setEnvironment shell script. Run it by source env/setenv.sh. Go through the setup step by step. Pick your device, mine in this case is VIM 1S. Choose bootloader. In fact, this is not a choice as there is only one option, and that is the U-boot. Choose OS you want to use. I'll use Debian, and as the release I'll pick Bullseye. Type I'll pick server as I don't want any GUI for the headless version. And why I want to burn this image to an SD card, so I choose the SD USB card option. And the last thing is that I don't need to compress this image. Okay, we now have the environment prepared for creating this image. But let's pause here and think a few steps ahead. If we create this image, burn it to an SD card, put it in the Khadas device and launch it headlessly without keyboard and display, how will we access this new server? See the problem here? We don't want to snoop around our network to determine which IP address could be this new Khadas device, no. We want to set static IP address of this device before we even launch it for the first time. The question is there a way to do this? Of course there is. That's what this tutorial is about. Linux kernel or the system's very core enables us to do this. But we need to set it the right way. There are two parts to this. First, you need to enable in the Linux kernel something that is called config IP PNP. I'm not sure what it means exactly, but in my head it always will be plug and play IP address. The help text says about this configuration item this. This enables automatic configuration of IP addresses of devices and of the routing table during kernel boot, based on either information supplied on the kernel command line or by bootp or reverse ARP protocols, blah 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 blah. The first time I did this, I built the image and kernel assuming this would be enabled by default, as is on Raspberry Pi.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Was I wrong? So the search for what is wrong had just started. Long story short, I've run this command on freshly downloaded Fenix script directory. grep -rn --e config ip pnp. It searches the contents of files And as you can see, there are a few entries about this config item in the Fenix script. See, it's enabled for VIM 1 and Edge 1 devices, but nowhere else. Notice that VIM 1 and VIM 1S are not the same devices. And in generic.config, it's stated is not set, which means that by default or for any other devices, it's turned off. Why? No one knows. So let's change this. VIM packages, Linux mainline, configs, generic.config. Find the line with /ip_pnp. Yep, it's here. Hit enter and I to switch to edit mode. Uncomment this line and set it to =y. Save the file with escape:wq. The creator of this script should enable it by default for all the Khadas devices. This just makes working with Khadas devices more of a pain in the a.
What are you doing, step bro?
Okay, that's the first part of this IP address issue. If this tutorial helps you, I'd appreciate you helping me by hitting that like and subscribe button. Thanks! Now, we can jump back and continue creating our image. If you're creating an Ubuntu image, you can simply run make command and create the image. If you're creating a Debian image and this bug or issue wasn't resolved by now, you need to use this command skip header deb =yes make. Otherwise, the script will fail when trying to build the image. According to Khadas support on their forum, there is an issue between Debian version 10, which is used on VIM devices, and Debian 11, which is the current version of Debian that I've used as a host to build this image. Whether this issue is resolved by the time you're watching this or not, you better keep that in mind. Okay, let's do this. Hit enter and wait. This will take a significant amount of time, so go grab a coffee or lunch. Oof. That took so long. After this is finished, you should see a path to the created image. You need to take this image and burn it to an SD card. You can do this from a terminal using the dd command, like this. For clarity, I moved this image to one of my Raspberry Pis and I'll burn it to an SD card from there. So let's do ls to see the image file and lsblk to see the devices attached. In my case, sda is the SD card attached to the USB computer reader. Sudo dd input file is vim1s Debian image and output file is dev sda. Block size is 4 MB, status equals progress. Or use any other software you like Balana Etcher. And here comes the second part of the IP address setup. After the image is burned to the card, there will be two partitions created. The first is a boot partition with uBoot bootloader, and the second contains actual system data. You need to mount the first partition, the boot partition, and edit the file named uenv.txt. In my case, I did it like this. Sudo mount devsda1 to media USB 1 and vim media USB 1 uenv.txt. Have a look at it. What does interest us here is the boot user args line, where you can set up our IP address, gateway, and so on. The structure of this line goes like this: IP equals client IP address colon optional NFS server IP address colon gateway IP address colon netmask colon hostname colon interface and colon auto configuration. So in my case, it looked like this: boot user args equals IP equals 10.0.0.104 colon 10.0.0.138 colon 255.255.255.0 colon Khadas VIM1S colon ETH0 colon off. So you see, 10.0.0.104 is the IP address of my VIM1S. Colon means I skip the NFS server IP address as I don't need it. Then my gateway address, network mask, and I've picked Khadas VIM1S as a host name for this device. ETH0 is LAN interface on Khadas device, and I've set auto configuration to off as I'm setting a static IP address to this device right now. And that's it. I'll save the file and exit it with escape colon WQ. Unmount the SD card partition with sudo umount media USB 1. Eject the SD card and stick it into the Khadas device. Connect the network Ethernet and power cable to it and let it start. One thing to mention here is to give it several minutes for the first boot to finish. There will be a few longer tasks running, like file system resizing and so on. And if everything went according to the plan, we should be able to connect to this device or Nano server via SSH from our workstation or laptop. Let's try that. I'll open the PuTTY SSH client and fill in Khadas, that's the username, at 10.0.0.104 and hit open. Fill in the password, which is Khadas again. And here we are, logged into our device, free to do whatever we like. It wasn't as easy as it could be, but I still think it's not super hard to use Khadas devices as microservers for whatever stuff you want. And if you saw my previous review video about Khadas VIM 1S, you know even the cheapest of the Khadas VIM line devices can easily handle many tasks, like serving as media center to stream your favorite movies around your network, or host a fleet of Docker containers performing various tasks. That's it for today. Please do hit that like and subscribe button down below. Bye!